volunteer at the Church of Jesus Christ of Latter-day Saints Family History Center every Wednesday night, and I work with people wanting to learn their genealogy and know more about their ancestors. I also crochet blankets and hats and things for people who are in need, like cancer patients. I do hats for them, and I do blankets for students who have babies, or for even for staff who have babies here at Northwest. I have been doing genealogy for, boy, about 15 years, and I have been crocheting for probably 30. To see the joy in other people's faces, to help other people feel better about themselves, and to just light up the world. I like to light up the world. The satisfaction of doing something for somebody else. It just makes me feel warm and fuzzy inside, and I need that for myself, because I battle from depression myself, and so when I do this, it brings back more to me.
I volunteer at a therapeutic riding center. Kind of walk around with some of the kids and the horses, handle the horses. You have to, some of the kids aren't fully, they aren't fully like responding to the animal. So you walk with them and you walk with the horse and you interact with them while they're grooming the horses and stuff. And a huge range of kids. Some of them have emotional traumas that have had in the past. Some of them are born special needs, but overall it's just a lot of different kids. It's very rewarding to see these kids smiling and having fun. I mean, you get a lot out of it, whether, I don't know, you put so much time into it. You see them grow, you see them develop. You build these relationships with these kids and these horses at the same time. I make a lot of friends. You make friends with the people that you help out with, you make friends with the animals that you work with, and the kids that you help every day.
We volunteer at Aberdeen Village.
Oh, okay, and then.
Okay, so my story, I worked at the occupational therapy, like physical therapy room, the rehab room, that's what it is. And this lady came in, and normally she's like very whiny and she like cries the whole time because she's in so much pain. Anyway, so I was there and she came in, she's like, "Oh, hello," and I was like, "Hi," and like, so they started like telling her the exercises to do, and instead of crying, like, she'd act like she forgot like how many she'd do. She goes, "Guess I have to start over," and then she'd like do like 5 extra ones, and then she'd be like, "And one to grow on," and then she'd like look at me and she's like, "Girls just have to have fun, you know," and then like she was just like giggling, and she's like, "I think laughter is the best medicine," and like then she's like, "It was so nice to meet you," and she's like, "Can you come back next time?" And like, I don't know, she was really cute, and like, yeah, just, it was adorable. And then the occupational therapy people were like, "Can you come back every day so she doesn't cry?" And like, she was trying, and it was sweet, and it was, yeah, okay, yeah.
We've been volunteering at the Olathe YMCA Child Learning Center. It's from infants to pre-K, and a lot of the kids, they're actually separated into different classrooms, and so when we get there, it's nap time, so we kind of have to help them with snack time and waking up, and they're all kind of learning how to potty train, so it's kind of fun that you kind of get to help you through that like life process with them. And at the end of the day, they do this little like song session, and one of the little girls, the song's called "On Your Head," so they take your name and they say, "This is on like Mayra's head." And so I had my hair up in a bun one day, and the little girl, her name's Naomi, she was like, "Well, let's do Bailey." I was like, "Okay." And they're like, "Bailey, what's on your head?" And she goes, "Bailey has a bird's nest on her head." And I was just like, "Oh." But I was like, it was really cute. But it's just cute because they, even though you've only been with them for a couple of days, they kind of learn to look up to you, and you kind of feel that compassion that you are worth it to someone that doesn't even really know you.